Alright, so if you know your harmony parts really well, take these front microphones down front. Does anyone need a lyric sheet? Does everyone have lyric sheets? Who's off book?
Hello! No speeches today, just some words from Steve, book 2, page 430. When Wilson Meisner came out of a coma and saw a priest standing over him, he reportedly said, "Why should I talk to you? I've just been talking to your boss." And promptly died. It's hard to believe he didn't work on it in advance, just as it's hard to believe that Oscar Wilde didn't work on either "That Wallpaper Goes" or "I Do," apocryphal or not. Or Goethe rehearsed "More Light." After all, they were writers. If I have the breath to gasp it out dramatically, mine will be a quote from our time, a song and merrily we roll along. There's so much stuff to sing. Page 32, on Sunday. This is the only lyric I've written that consists of one long, incomplete sentence. I wanted it to be like the descriptive caption you might read in a museum next to the painting. I hoped that the tone would echo the permanence of the painting, which is not only a miracle of composition and innovative technique, but also a satirical piece of reportage, something Lapine had pointed out to me. Seurat was as much a cartoonist as a painter. Once, during the writing of each show, I cry at a notion, a word, a chord, a melodic idea, an accompaniment figure. Only once in each case, curiously enough, since I'm an easy crier at works of art, particularly those made by others. For example, with "Anyone Can Whistle," it was the phrase "Hold Me," at the end of "With So Little to Be Sure Of," against the chord underneath. "Follies," it was the word "Home," and "The Right Girl." The Pacific Overture is the last line of "Someone in a Tree." "Only cups of tea and history and someone in a tree." And "Merrily We Roll Along," the vamp to our time. In this show, it was the word "forever" in Sunday. I was suddenly moved by the contemplation of what these people would have thought if they'd known they were being immortalized, and in a major way, in a great painting. I still cry when I think about it, but then I cry at Animal Planet. Often. One more line from James Lapine and we'll sing. White. A blank page or canvas. His favorite. So many possibilities.
On the green, the yellow, Well, we're gathered here on a Sunday. It's, you know, it's a song that no matter where you are and when you sing it, it brings so much meaning to, it brings us back to why his work means so much to us. So many people here, we have a point of light to why we're all here, and for so many of us, that point of light is the music of Sondheim's. And so, as we're all here mourning and we're all, you know, grieving the loss of one of the great masters of all time, what else can we do but to express that in song, and to express that in a song that has meant so much to us and will continue to mean so much to us over the course of our lives. So I'm happy to be here and see so many friends and do that.
Sondheim, for me, is the theater. He is, he represents excellence at theater at its best. No false rhymes, beautiful music. His music is, I think, perhaps my favorite to sing, because he's already thought out the character, he's thought out the thought in the music. He thinks the pauses, he thinks everything. He's already worked that out for you. I always say, I think his music is some of the easiest to sing, because if you just do what he wrote, you can't fail.
I think it's safe to say that no one would be here doing Broadway if it were not for Stephen Sondheim's contributions to our community, and so to honor him today is, we're just so lucky, and I'm so grateful to get to be here. Was a really powerful day.
He will always be a foundation of musical theater. You know, he provided such outlets and great work that so many of us got to relate to and got to express ourselves with. And the magic that he made with his creativity and his evolution and his process is just life lessons that us as theater people absorb to the fullest. So today is a celebration. Today is an exaltation of the magic and the man that is Stephen Sondheim.
It's weird. I feel like most people discover Sondheim alone. Someone hands them a tape, in my case, or a CD or something, and you listen to it in your bedroom, and then when you find out the rest of the world, the rest of the theater nerds love him as much as you do, that it starts with something very private and very public. So being here and singing with all of my peers and loved ones meant the world to me. And if you didn't cry when you sang Forever today, do you even have a heart?
So Eric Bergen had called me last night around 2:00 and said, you know, can we put something together? I think I'm thinking about doing something. Can we put something together in Times Square? And I was like, okay, you know, we're gonna try. And all of a sudden, 3 hours later, we had a sound company involved, we had an arrangement involved, we had to make a new track of Sunday. And you know, we woke up this morning and it was very much like Wayne's song. We thought, are people gonna come? And you know, they showed up, so we're really happy about it.
It came together very quickly. I had the idea yesterday afternoon at around noon, and by 1:00 we had this area done and secure, and then by 2:00 we were calling performers, and even up to 11 a.m. this morning I was getting emails from Josh Groban saying, I'm running over, I'll be right there. So it all came together miraculously, and of course you count on theater kids that you do that with a baton and everyone sings on exactly the right note. So it was quite a magical thing today.